That is the shout of victory. I want you to turn your Bibles to the book of Proverbs chapter 24. I'll start from verse 5. Proverbs 24, verse 5. Can I have it, please? Proverbs 24, verse 5. A wise man is strong. Yea, a man of knowledge increaseth what? Increaseth weakness. Is it strength? Maybe my Bible is different too. Okay, strength. He said a wise man is what? Strong. So for you to be a strong man, you must be wise. A wise man is strong. And a man of knowledge, you, no matter how educated you are, you must have what? Strength. If you are so educated and you don't have strength, means the education is wasted. No knowledge. A wise man increase strength, and a man of knowledge increaseth what? Strength. Wise man strong, who has knowledge increase what? Strength. Okay, I want to teach you about the weapon of bondage. One of the major weapons the devil uses to fight us and to bring us down. And that weapon is discouragement. Discouragement. It's a weapon of bondage. It's a major weapon that the devil uses to destroy man, to bring you down. Discouragement. You are discouraged in your marriage. You don't even know why. You are just discouraged. You are discouraged in your job. You don't know why. You are just discouraged. You are discouraged to look for money. You know what you do to make money. Now you are discouraged. You don't want to do your business again. And you can't really find any tangible reason for being discouraged. You used to wake up by 5 a.m. Now you wake up by 9. Not that you did an all night in the night. You are just discouraged. It's a weapon of bondage. It's a power of isolation. Coronavirus isolation. You are locked in a room. Nobody is meeting you. You are not meeting anybody. You are all alone. So you are on your own. So they can do whatever they want to do to you. To you, and nobody would know. When devil wants to bring down a man, the first thing he does is to isolate him. Stop going to that church. Stop! And you stop. Whether you stop or you don't stop, we will never know whether somebody like you did not come. After all, it's not you that fired the generator. Okay, now you have stopped. You are home doing nothing. Devils can deal with you, get you, reduce you to nothing. A wise man is strong. Yea, a man of knowledge increases what? Strength. So, a wise man always increases strength. It means a wise man encourages himself. He is wiser than the devil. He is smarter than the devil. I want you to turn your Bibles to the book of James, chapter 4, verse 7. Submit yourself, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will do what? Resist the devil, and he will do what? So before you can resist the devil, you must firstly submit yourself to... Okay, how strong are you to resist the devil? That is the question. I'm going to ask you, please answer me. How strong and skillful are you over the devil? How strong and skillful you are over the devil, right? I want to ask a question now. It is a practical church. The Bible says, resist the devil and he will flee. Before you resist the devil, it says, submit to God. So if you are not submissive to the things of God, you cannot resist the devil, because devil is a spirit. You cannot say, devil, go, and it will go. No. The only way you can resist the devil is to do the things of God. So devil does not have dominion over you. When he brings alcohol, you don't drink alcohol. He brings drugs, you don't drink drugs. You don't take drugs. Rather, he brings spirit of lust to flirt. You have self-control. You say, no, I don't flirt. My husband is Jesus. You have already resisted the devil. So you must have God in you before you can have the ability to resist the devil, right? That's why it says, submit to God and resist the devil. Now, the question is, how strong and skillful are you to overcome the devil? In other words, to overcome the devices of the devil. How strong and skillful are you? How? The title of my message is Discouragement. The weapons of bondage called discouragement. Discouragement, they call it despondency. Dispiritedness. What is happening? Sound room. You are discouraged. You are depressed. Depression. Dejection. Isolation. You are on your own. You don't want to hear anything any other person is saying. You are on an island of your own. You are moody. Either because you are going through one trouble or the other now, devils have worked on you. You are discouraged. I'm fed up. I have fasted. I have prayed. I have succeeded. It's not working. I want to kill myself. Devil will say, kill yourself. Kill yourself. What are you still waiting for? Die. Come here, you know. Fools. Somebody that thinks of killing himself is a fool. Big fool. It's the most foolish thought that could cross your mind. What are you going through? You think somebody hasn't gone through that is even worse than what you are going through. What are you going through? Brother was crying, I don't have a house. Another brother was telling him how him and his family, wife and children, were thrown out of the house, so they don't even have a house, him, his wife and children. He said, hey, me, now leave me. So even you with your wife and they throw all of your heart. Ooh. Discouragement is a weapon of bondage that devil uses to bring us down. You are discouraged to pray. You used to be a giver in church. Sound room. Who is there? You used to be a giver in church. You give. Now you are discouraged. You don't want to give. I beg. I don't want to give, Joe. I give. You know they work. What thing concern us? Whether you give, you not give. The church must move on. God will even bring more people that will give times than what you used to give. Who is blessing who? Is it you that is blessing the church, or the church is blessing you? Discouragement. It's a weapon of bondage. Devil at times, most times, not even at times, most times, will come up to you and start talking to you. You will not see him, but he's talking. All these shows you are going, don't you think they are just working on you? You are wasting your time. Things are even getting worse, don't you know? Now, how much do you have in your account? Tell me, how much do you have? You will die, you, the next one, Lalo will throw your heart. It's the devil that is working on you. You get discouraged. They say, we are going to show you, but you go, sure, I'm coming. It's a weapon of bondage. How smart, skillful, prepared are you over these devices of the devil? Because they must come, whether you like it or not. Devil must hit you with discouragement as you are seated there now. One day, if not today, devil must hit you with discouragement. You'll be discouraged. I'm sick and tired of this, my boyfriend. I'm tired. Are you sure I'm going to marry this man? I don't think so. Meanwhile, you were praying for him. You have prayed like 1 to 2 years for God to bring somebody like him. Now he has come. You are discouraged. I don't think I can go on with this guy. Let him go. Go! Then you start another 2 years prayer again. It's a weapon of bondage. You are in a marriage, you have beautiful children. You say, I'm tired. I don't want to marry again. So go and start another life. In short, I can marry anybody and move on. It's a weapon of bondage called despondency, discouragement. The weapon of bondage. Bible said, be vigilant, be watchful, be at alert, because the devil is moving about as a roaring lion looking for who to destroy. And one of the weapons devils can use to destroy you fast is discouragement. At times, you will even be discouraged of life. I do the same business with people. They are making money. I'm not making money. Why? I'm sick and tired. He said, anything they say I should do, I will do. What do you want a human head? I will give it to you. I can kill anybody. I must have the money. You kill. The money didn't stick on. Ooh. The next thing they say, okay, it's your head. They want to cut now. Would you donate your head? You cannot. So now you are even confused. Devil uses discouragement to bring frustration. You'll be so frustrated. Then you leave the path of God. You join the path of the devil. Then you'll be desperate. You can't do anything. Because you feel you've tried everything. They are not working. Meanwhile, you are fooling yourself. You might be doing the same business with people. And God chooses to make sure your own is not working. Because you are not matured enough. Oh, you don't know. You are not matured enough. God wants you to know him more so that you can be matured. God does not, it's not by age. Maturity is not age. God does not want to invest an investment that will waste. God does not lift people up and bring them down. That is not God. When God raises you up, you will just be going up, 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 and up. It's devils that brings people down. How prepared are you to overcome the devil? The devil will always fight you. Okay, for instance, I want to ask a question. I said I will ask a question. For instance, who I want to ask now? Brown Tennyson. You have a very fine car, right? For instance, they now said one pole just four. Now it four for your motor, share into two. That week, you feel go church. Okay, now you come outside, no motor to drive, go church. Rain the fall and Okada night day. Okada said, rain they beat you. The seats don't wet. Then you remember your cozy car and the way the air condition the she. Motor does scatter beyond repair. No money to buy another one, for instance. You feel go church. Be truthful, though.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you now just in a tree they talk. When I think I well, low. No, this is reality. Just in a tree, they read the talk.
Yes, sir.
Okay, wait. For you, it's, yes, sir. Just hold on. Hold on there with the mic. This line, I just in a tree. know it's more. Oh, that's just in a tree talk. For instance, moto scatter. Yeah? The sweet car, when you pass, all the guests go, they look at you. Ooh, see, car. Okay, now moto does scatter. Right? Naturally, devil will come with discouragement, strong discouragement. Yeah? Okay, to capital, rain started falling. Better rain. You can't manage to see only one Okada. You don't stand for your junction like 25 minutes. All the Okada, they fool people, they rush you. That time, it will look as if you are the enemy of the people. Because any Okada you want to enter, somebody will just dive it. Ah, you say, oh God. Oh my God. Okay, the only Okada that came, now rain has beaten him and the seat is wet. And you dress very well for your car, no car. Will you like to go to church? This line. Who say yes? Let me see your hand. You're not going to bring your hand. Only you. You will come, eh? Only him or everybody know. You know, it's a reality church, right? TMG. Okay, I'm still coming with one question. Okay, now, naturally, even if it's Pastor Taiwo, he will be discouraged, right? The car is supposed to use to church, sir, your fine car, for instance. Eh? And you know, say your wife picked to enter Okada the hand. Nah, the car just torn, wanted just spoil. No car to use, go church this evening and rain the fall. Naturally, you'll be discouraged, right? Then you got stop Okada. As you stop the Okada, Okada just look you like this. Nice. If you not pay 150, and they carry you and just the ride they go. You know this Okada. Devil send the come from here to torment you. As you say, Okada, TMG, oh, that church. When I get money, where? TMG, not fun. I might give 50 naira. It's in 100 naira. In short, if you not pay 150, I'm not going to carry you. And you can't remember your car. You feel bad, right?
Yes, sir.
It's not easy.
It's not easy.
You can't trek small for the road. To capital, one madman just drive motor, splash water on your body again. That is how devil works.
It's true.
Eh?
Yes, sir.
You may be seated, sir.
Thank you, sir.
You'll be so disappointed and discouraged. Devil is already working on you. Devils are fighting you now. They want to stop you. They want to discourage you. Not only by church, even in your marriage. Devils can bring discouragement like that. Pack your things. Leave this house. Go home. Go home. Go village. Go village. You don't. Is this life you are living? Is this one life? See what your mates are doing. You are still here. The years, you know. The year has gotten to half. You have never seen 100,000. Is this life you are living? Right? True or false? It's a weapon of bondage of the devil that will make you to be in thoughts. You just sit down. Your wife bring food. Your wife will come back. The food is still there. Sir, honey, eat now. I will eat. I will eat. You just be thinking. Devils are working on you. Discouragement. What you do to make money now, you don't want to do again. You don't want to call any of your customers. You don't want to even go to work. You are discouraged. It's a weapon of the devil. Don't be ignorant of it, oh. Don't forget that. So you ought to be strong against it. When it's coming, your ability to see that, this is discouragement too. I'm not smart the way I used to be smart. I'm not fast the way I used to be fast. I'm not doing my job the way I used to do it. That means I'm going to lose this job if I continue like this. Let me add more. That is that Proverbs 24:5. Can I have it again? Proverbs 24:5. Ecclesiastes 10:10. Just give me the Proverbs 24:5 first. Can we have the scripture again? I have one question. Proverbs 24:5. Brother Tennessee, I have one question. You've been in this church for about 3 years and you've gone through a lot of challenges in the church, right? You've sold one of your car before in this church.
Yes, sir.
Eh? For the church, your car that dropped you, your car that still dropped them. You call look you. You don't need to kind of like me, I'll be. Never see anything. I'll soup around my shoe. Oh, you don't know? I was going to a church in Warri, in Ojagugbe. You know, when the brothers, they buy things, I would buy. It's a small church. I always buy the best for God. I bought plasma TV like this many, many years ago, about 8 years ago. The TV not come on. I bought it. It's not Thanksgiving. I just gave it to the church. I'm a madman now. Mad. If you never mad for Jesus, you cannot make heaven. No. If you have not been mad for Jesus, you can't. Will you make heaven? Mad. I can just be passing. I just see one thing. I'll branch. I'll buy it. TV like this. I got to the pastor's house yesterday. I saw the TV. You saw it. They inside his own house, his parlor, he put on there. I didn't buy it for pastor. I bought it for the church. I just carry a control for altar. I said, pastor, I brought this TV. On a radio, I brought this TV. Pastor will be blowing the trumpet. It's Brother Morgan that bought that TV you are seeing now. Brother Morgan, all the brothers go the verse for me. They show itself for this church. They show itself. They show itself for this. My motor go to spoil any hour. Why not go spoil any hour? All of them hate me. I know things like that are still here too. Okay, that time that you sold your car, things became rough. At times you come with your friends, no car to drive, nothing to drive, no money at all. There were even times you could not have transport fare to go back to Igrovie.
That's true, sir. And even sometimes you were the one going to drop us after the service.
Okay, at times I will even go and drop them to tell you how things bad rich, no transport. Some of you are like that here now. You feel, I have been coming to this church. Things are not still working for me. He's telling you his own. Things was rich, no transport to go home. And his place is Igrovie, he cannot trek. Before I go trek reach there, they should not go. Okay. I want to ask you one more question. What was encouraging you then? What was your weapon? What were you doing to... Because devils were definitely attacking you to stop, right? Attacking you to stop praying. Attacking you to stop the things of God. Devils were talking to you, go to native doctor, go to native... Why you not just... That time, devil will even be bringing friends that will tell you, follow me, I'll take you, go somewhere for Okitikpukpa, right?
That's
I know some I get many friends. I know I'm not the one.
Yes, sir.
Just do this thing, do that thing, do that thing. You will just blow, making money, right?
Yes, sir.
But you choose not to do it. What were your weapon? What were your skills? What was keeping you going on? What were you doing? That's what I want you to tell us. Because we have a lot of persons here that are like you and are going through tough times right now and they are getting discouraged. Why were you not discouraged then? What were you doing? What were you doing to encourage yourself, to keep on coming and praying and believing that God is going to make you to be rich one day? What were you doing? I want you to think back, remember, and tell us. What were you doing then?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There were so many reasons why I never stopped coming to church then. And number one was the testimonies of people.
Oh, the testimonies of other people.
Yes, sir.
That you will hear.
Yes, sir.
This person make 10 million. That means my uncle see come one day. Right? So you were encouraged.
Yes, sir.
By their testimonies.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead. And one testimony.
Number one, I'll say reason, like when I came to the church, I had an issue. It was like a police case.
Okay, when you came to the church, you had a police case before you came.
Yes, it was my former neighbor at Munyame that invited me.
Okay.
I explained to him that I was having some
police trouble.
Police case, and
that was why I invited you to this church.
Yes,
I didn't even know this. Go ahead.
To the point that my bank account,
yes,
my two bank accounts, they are more than First Bank. They both were frozen.
They were frozen.
Yes.
I didn't even know this. They freeze all their accounts. And police,
yes, sir.
Go ahead.
And the bank started calling me. But luckily, I was having a friend then working in First Bank. So he asked me not to go. That if I go,
they will arrest you.
That it was an EFCC case. So that was the reason I came. And I met.
That was what brought you to TMG.
Yes, sir.
Oh, now. Wow.
And I met with you then. And there was, I think it was on this Thursday service. Then we're still doing counseling.
Counseling every service. Thursday. That is here before last.
Me and my friend, we came and we spoke. Like you advised us and so many things. Like most things I did in the past, before then I didn't even know anything about TMG. I was so surprised that most things I did in the past that I didn't even tell anybody. You're able to tell me everything, and then that was actually what made me to stay back.
That was what motivated you
to stay back.
Then the police case, God also took it away.
Yes.
That was what also encouraged you.
Yes.
To be coming.
And you prayed for me that period. And you said, you told me not to worry that. In due time that the account will be
restored.
And after three, to 4 months, the account was restored. And
they restored their account back.
And the case died.
The case died. Yes. Can you put your hands together? You see, he had his own testimony. I didn't even know of this, sir. Right? So you had your own testimony. So when you were going through tough times, you remember what God has done for you.
Yes, sir.
When discouragement comes, you remember the good things God has done.
Yes, sir.
That was what was keeping you going.
Yes, sir.
So when there were no even one naira in your pocket to fare, you will also look for transport and come to church.
Yes, sir.
You were encouraged that God is going to do it.
Yes, sir.
As far as doing it for others, he's going to do for me too.
Yes,
as far as he has done for me in the past, he's going to do another one.
Yes,
can you put your hands together? You may be seated. Your weapon over the devil. You see his own case, I didn't even know of all this. Your weapon, you need to also, devils are working on us. You also ought to know how to work on the devil. Right? You must know how to work on the devil. Devils are, a sister sent me a message. Prophet, I heard a voice telling me, don't go to that church again, stop going. I've been waiting for her to stop. You stop, you fail. You failed yourself. You failed God. You are in a powerful church. They are fighting you. What about when you stop coming? What will happen? They will not even fight you again. They will not fight you again. A sister called me this morning from Enugu. He said, Prophet, now that I started praying more, the troubles increase. I cannot sleep. Oh, if I close my eyes, devils everywhere fighting me. I say, yes. He said, how will the trouble stop? I say, if you stop praying, it will stop. He said, ah, Prophet, what are you saying? I say, if you stop praying, the trouble will stop now. You are in a cage, right? You want to break the cage out. Eh? For instance, you get foul with this side cage. Before you come, the foul does scatter your cage. You don't go out. What will you do? You go and look for the foul. Tie his feather and fling him inside the cage. I cover the cage back. Is that not what you do? That's what the devil does. You are in a cage, you break loose. Devils will fight you non-stop. When they put you back into the cage, they will leave you. So when you really want to be delivered, you fight. They will increase their fight. Oh, increase your own too. Don't stop. You pray, 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 pray. They come to make love to you. Increase the prayer. They give you food. Pray. Don't stop. Continue. Don't stop. When they try. You did not stop. They will then withdraw. They will withdraw. But you will fight. Oh, you must fight. The Bible said in that, is it Psalm or Proverbs 5? It said, deliver thyself as a roe from the hunter and as a bird from the fowler. Deliver thyself. I think that is Psalm 5. 5 or Proverbs 5. Deliver yourself. You must deliver yourself. So you fight. You fight the battle of your life. You must fight it. Don't be discouraged, right? Don't let, in that your marriage, don't be discouraged. In that school you are going to now, don't be discouraged, yo. At times, money will discourage you. You don't even know where the next school fees will come from. You say, oh, this school, I will go put myself safe. Let me tell you, any relationship that will work, discouragement must come. Those of you that are not yet married, any relationship that will work, discouragement. If discouragement never come for your relationship, no say not to take you go anywhere. True or false? They didn't answer me. Okay, can I add that Proverbs 24, verse 10. Proverbs 24, verse 10. If thou offend in the day of adversity, what is adversity? Huh? Thy strength is trouble can come. Now you faint. People they fight, you faint. It means you are not ready. People are fight and say, hey, fight, don't call. Hey, people they fight. There's always day for trouble. Oh, you don't know. That's how God designed this world. People are fighting. Now, as you see the fight, now you faint. That means you have a problem. If your strength fails you, can I have the scripture, please, on the screen? If thou faint in the day of adversity, thy strength is small. That is King James. The New King James says, If you faint in the day of adversity, your strength is small. New International Version. New International Version. If you falter in a time of trouble, how small is your... He has it here, New International Version. Are you seeing it? If you falter in times of trouble, how small is your time of trouble? Now you dey shake, you dey run. How small is your strength? The Amplified Version. If you are slack, careless in the day of distress, your strength is limited. New Living Translation. If you fail under pressure, you see, they didn't use trouble here, they use pressure. Yes, thank God you have it. If you fail under pressure, you are under pressure. Landlord is disturbing you. The children's school fees are disturbing you. Everywhere trouble. You borrowed money someone. The person is disturbing you. Hey, bring my money. That is pressure. It's trouble. You are under pressure. You are under pressure. Your mother is calling you. You don't want to marry, eh? You don't want to say you're the old. Please marry. Oh, I want to carry my grandchildren. Hey, so you don't want me to carry my grandchildren. Marry. You are under pressure. Your father will call you. You have not married yet. What is wrong with you? Hope you don't have problem. If you have problem, come. I will take you to Igbe. They will bait you. You will marry. You are under pressure. Right? Now you are under pressure. Right? Okay. You are under pressure. If you fail under pressure, your strength is... It didn't say small. It said your strength is what? It said a brave man smiles in the face of adversity. Because adversity must come. You have to be strong. Somebody dupes you. Then you have to kill yourself. Do you have to kill yourself because you were duped? What if they cut off your neck? What would have happened? You are still alive. It means there is hope. It means you move on. It means you make more money. Let me give you a scripture that will make you see why God allows trouble. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10. Can I have it on the screen? 1 Peter. Am I correct? I believe so. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10. I want to tell you why God allows trouble, right? Can we all read it together? 1, 2, go. But the God of all grace, who hath... Did you understand that, please? Now, I know you want me to pray for you and prophesy for you and do all that. But if you don't know the word, if you don't know the word, devil will be raking you like ball. Our footballer will be raking like ball. If you don't know God's word, you ought to be grounded in God's word. Can we read it again? 1, 2, go. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen. Oh, you see, so God allows distress, pressure, trouble, because he wants you to be what? Perfect. The first one here is what? Perfect. To make you perfect. So God wants a perfect you. God wants a better you. God wants you perfect. He said, no man is perfect. You can be perfect, right? After that, the next one he's doing for you with those trouble you are going through is to establish you. Say, believe the Lord thy God and you shall be established. Establish proper foundation. You are strong. They push you. You can't shake. That is what God wants, to establish. Because devil will use all his koni to push you down. You will fall flat. So if you are not established, you are not fit for the kingdom of God yet. Devils can still brush you. You fall. Right? So the next thing God wants you to do is to establish you firm, solid foundation. The third one God wants to do for you with the stress you are going through now is to do what? To strengthen you. You need bones, right? So that you can have what? Bones. You have strength, right? You can move a mountain. You are not afraid of the devil and his troubles. We were praying this afternoon, and somebody said, Prophet, I'm seeing two dragons. They join hands together. I laugh. I said, dragon, forget. We go toast them. No, no, no. You don't believe the way they will fall. They were looking at me. We prayed. Where are they? We toast the dragon, right? Toast the two of them. We have been seeing one dragon for almost 10 days. Now, every day, now, we reckon. We toast them. Today, somebody said, Prophet, I saw in the sea, they opened a gate, and a big dragon came out. I said, okay. Another one came out to join this one with the pigeons. Now, they are not two. They didn't join hands together. They thought maybe I would be shaking. I said, hey, don't worry. You see, I will toast this dragon. We toast them. Not be so. They run, lost. God came from heaven and increased us. We became bigger than all the dragon. The church became so big than the dragon. Dragon became like ants. But when they say, hey, prophet, the open sea dragon came out. I said, hey, you were there now. I started shaking. I said, hey, only one dragon. I would fight for 2 weeks now. The dog will bring another one. No. But we fast first. When we fast 3 days, we'll go pray the prayer. You are already defeated. You are defeated. So don't be moved by what you see, right? Don't be. God allowed what you are going through now because he wants to strengthen you. Can I have the scripture? He wants to strengthen you. He wants you to be strong. He wants you to be strong. Proverbs 24:5. God wants you to be strong. The next one, which is the last one, God will then do what? Settle you. Maybe before, you did pray for 500,000. God can just give you 50 million. Is that not settlement? God, give me any husband, whether I tall, whether I short, whether I fat, whether I thin. I don't care to know. Whether I poor self, any husband, just give me husband. God wants to settle you. He will give you a man that is rich, very rich. He will first transform your family, transform. You don't see man. As you meet an lady, you go say, see, all this your clothes you are wearing now, I don't want you to wear anyone with me. You go to fear. What do you mean? When will I have a... He said, don't worry, let me. I will take you to a boutique and worry. Don't come change your wardrobe, up to your pants. You change everything. All your old clothes, say, use them, dash. It does start. From there, go to position everybody. Now your sister, which school should they go? She never go school. Put her, let me take her to Unilag. What about this one? This, you people should move from this house. This house is too small for you people. Come to this house first. Don't worry. He has plans. He go change the full family. Is that not settlement? You never get hope of buying a Lexus before you know you don't buy Lexus 350. The drive. Is that not settlement? So if you, no matter what you are going through, see the end result. That is the settlement. The child is the settlement. The breakthrough is the settlement. God must settle you. It's the scripture that says it. Now me talking. 1 Peter 5:10. I said God must settle you. Be strong. God must settle you. See. Let me tell you. I went through my own. Beauty say now let you go through stress. This church you are seeing started in my in-law's house. I have a house in Warri. I have a house in Lagos. God brought me to Ogeli. I came to Ogeli to see my mother-in-law. I didn't come to do church. If I were told I would do church, I would laugh you, me. Do we church? God disturbed me for a long time. It's sure God started using my wife to talk to me. I say, you they lie. I mean, won't be beggar. All those pastors will be beggar. Where they lie. No. I don't want to do pastor work. I have money. You know what God did? God frustrated everything. I was there in my in-law's house. I didn't plan to go to my in-law's house to stay. I went there to see my in-laws and go back home. We came from Lagos to see and go back. Now we did so. The church started in my in-law's house. No room. It's a big house, over 6-bedroom flat. But people food the whole house. So we started praying. We have to even pray one of my wife's senior sister to marriage. She must go. She must marry. Night and day I was praying. She must marry. Husband came, they married her away. The day they were taking her away, we were happy, drawing out the go-go rat. I'm not just saying that motor devil go before we park enter the room. She's happy they go, we're happy they enter our new room. You don't see something? It was like no hope for tomorrow. Church now, poverty. Church, where just start? No money. Nobody they give you 5 naira. And we never know say they give people money. That is how we started. Has God not settled me? See my car outside. See all of you. Has he not settled me? Oh, I said God will settle you. In your marriage, God will settle you. In your childbearing, God will settle you. In your finances, my God will settle you. You will be so rich. Money will be your slave. Money will be your slave. God will settle all your children. You will surpass your expectations. In the mighty name of Jesus. Those of you that are building houses now, all those are baby houses. You will build bigger houses. In the name of Jesus. You will buy bigger lands. You will build estates. In the mighty name of Jesus. You that looks as if it's not working, it's not working, it's not working. When it will start, God will harass you. God will embarrass you with favor. In the mighty name of Jesus. There's a brother that was coming to this church. 1 year, nothing was happening. 2 years, nothing. Brother Ogaga, I said, when I saw the wife's face just now. 3 years, nothing was happening. At a point, I became afraid. I said, this guy go leave this church. Nothing they walk on. When God started with him, today we never see him again. Hey, Ade Bayesa. Ade Lagos. Prophet, you know I'm very busy now. I say now, wow. This blessing, they call it everybody affect us now because we know they see you, they do our work again. Prophet, God dedicate my land. I don't build. No, I stop this one first. I buy another land for this side. Man, start this one. His church is even confused. You know what they call blessings? When it started, people will be giving you name. As I'm here, so many people, they don't understand. So they call me name. He went to buy power. Don't trust him. All those men of God, they do not. Because God has started blessing me. When I was suffering in the love venue in my in-laws' house, they didn't see me then. Some of you are trekking now. Your slippers has got to get up. Right? You are trekking. Almost all the Okada riders don't know you. Let me tell you, God will settle you. Jesus will settle you. Amen. This year is your year.
Amen.
Forget coronavirus. 2020 is your year.
Amen.
Gosh, you will not understand. God makes ways where there are no way. If you think God will program something and you will be seeing it, okay, by October, money is going to come from this place. That is not God. God brings money from where? A sister, she's here. You heard a testimony on Sunday. She said they were writing for a bus, right? We are bought the first bus now, we're on the second one. They were writing for a bus, right? People were giving. A brother even gave 500,000 today. Okay, people were giving for the bus. Some wrote secretly. That is how we do it in this church. It's a very civilized church. They were just giving people pieces of paper that day. They were write. Some 50,000, some 10,000, some 500,000, some 1 million. They were writing. It got to the sister. The sister wrote. She wanted to write. 1 million. While she was writing, she didn't even have 50,000 of her own. But she wrote 1 million naira. She just wrote it, 1 million. Right? Okay, to capital, coronavirus struck. No way to do business again, right? People were locked out and locked down, right? It became worse. It's like, no hope. I don't want to call her out now, but I know what she went through. No hope. No prospect of making money at all. See, if you are expecting money from this side and you place all your hope there, by October, I'm going to make 10 million. God does not work like that to you. God will just walk from where you never expected. Before you know, millions have started coming. The sister was not expecting it. From nowhere, within some days, I told you, I said the money they used to live life, they don't work for a long time for it. It will just come. Within some days, the money came. She gave the 1 million naira on Monday. She didn't even know. She just had 1 million. She gave the 1 million. She didn't know. God will settle you. God will settle you. In the mighty name of Jesus. No matter how many the enemies are, my Jesus will settle you. He will settle you. In the presence of all your enemies, he will settle you. In the presence of all your enemies, you will marry. In the presence of all your enemies, you will buy that car. In the presence of all your enemies, you will travel all over the world. Jesus will settle you. You will carry that baby. In the presence of all your enemies.